Yo, what's good, YouTube, man? As you can see yesterday, my boy Andrew Tate got banned from Instagram, I think Facebook too. But he was live with Aiden. I didn't watch the live stream. I'm probably gonna watch it later on. But we got Andrew Tate reacts to being banned on Instagram on Aiden live. Before we get this video started, make sure you guys hit that like button and subscribe button. Without further ado, let's get this started.
Instagram a couple hours ago wouldn't let me. I have good people on the case. I trust due process with Instagram. I'm actually quite understanding of their position. I do understand it very, very well. I'm not angry at them in any regard. It's not a big loss for me. It's not something I use too often. But I do understand their position because we're actually living in a world now where it's kind of strange. This is an unprecedented period of human history. And we have internet sensationalism, global sensationalism on a scale which has never happened before. And also, we have the ability to edit things so quickly, right? So you can say something on a stream and they can remove all context, or you can say something and they can change the tone of your voice, or you can
it's already happened to me many times, yes.
Exactly. And then what they can do is they can throw that in front of a hate mob, and then internet sensationalism can take control, and people can start to believe in narratives which are false, and then people have to take some kind of action against that. So I understand all these things. I understand that with great power and great influence comes great responsibility. And I'm very understanding of the situation. I think that I'm a strongly religious man. I believe that God will prevail, the truth will prevail.
Right.
The one thing that's a little bit annoying, I mean, because a lot of people have been insulting me for a long time on all platforms. And that's fine. It really doesn't bother me because I'm an extremely strong person. I know that some people would be very, very uncomfortable in my position. Not many people can sleep at night with the kind of death threats I've been getting, but for me it's been fine, right?
Getting death threats?
Well, yeah, I get to and this is the thing that's crazy, right? So I would get 10 to 20,000 death threats a day.
What?
Via Instagram.
Via Instagram.
And they would take no action, even if I reported them. However, they've now decided I'm the danger. And even the people who were supporting me, I was thinking, crazy, yeah. I was saying, look, if you're going to support me in public, if you're going to discuss things in the comments, please do it respectfully, because hate on hate, it ain't going to get
I have a question. Right? The guy saying that the DMs are going to kill you, be honest, if they saw you in person, do you think they'd give us a man of you?
I of course not, you know, but it's still, it's just about the fact that, you know, there's a lot of hate around on the internet, and I don't believe that hate versus hate is going to win.
So Andrew, what I've learned on the internet now, it's a new generation of internet. The internet is different now, and whatever you say that is hateful gets more likes, more clicks, and it gets more attention. Yeah. Because listen, you probably get thousands of comments that are showing love and appraisal, right? But the ones that stick out the most are the hate ones, the ones that are like, he's really saying that shit. So that's how they do it. They do it because they want the clicks, they want the attention, they want the likes, that's really what they do.
Yeah, and it's really interesting about how it's going to shape the world, right? Because, like I said, with great power comes great responsibility. Now I have millions and millions of people who are my fans, and I was literally teaching them and telling them on Instagram 3 days ago, if you want to defend me, then stick up for me in a respectful way. Even if they're insulting me or threatening my life, do it in a respectful way, because just arguing back and forth in a bigger, immature, hate-on-hate way isn't going to work. Show that if you're a fan of Andrew Tate, you're a respectful person. And I was trying to teach respect to all these millions of young men. And now, who knows where they're going to go, right? And you're right. It's kind of crazy where the internet has all these black holes of pure degeneracy or hatred, because that's what gets the most views.
It does. It does. It does. Now, I want to ask you a question. Let me move on to the next thing. Andrew,
Oh shit. Well, there you have it, man, for Andrew Tate reacts to being banned on Instagram Live. I think it's messed up because it's not what? Freedom of speech. Ain't that like the First or Second Amendment or something like that? But yeah, it's messed up to take away his Instagram just like they did Trump. But, yeah, man, y'all let me know how y'all feel about that down in the comments, man. I mean, you can hate him, you know what I'm saying? But, you know what I'm saying? Why take away his Instagram? It's freedom of speech. And all that stuff, I forgot. I think it is the Second or Third Amendment. But yeah, that's messed up though. But it looked like he don't really care. Like you said, he barely used it. So,